Hey everyone! In the following videos, we are going to take a look at the emergence of Western psychology. In this video, we are going to discuss about the three periods in Western psychology. They are the Greek heritage, the medieval period, and the modern period. Till the middle of the 19th century, psychology was considered as a branch of philosophy. The history of psychology as a study of mind and behavior dates back to the ancient Greeks. The word psychology itself is derived from the Greek word psyche, which literally means life. Let us now discuss about some of the scientists among Greeks who contributed to psychology. Homer introduced the concept that the heart is the origin of feelings and thoughts through his poems, the Iliad and Odyssey. Heraclitus believed that all people possess logos, or the ability to reason but do not make use of it. He believed that the key to understanding was introspection. Thales is known as the first Greek philosopher. His contributions to psychology were his discussion of the nature of matter. Alcmaeon was the first to define the difference between men and animals. Men differ from animals by the power of understanding. He identified the brain as the seat of consciousness and called it the soul. He also believed that the brain not only received perceptions of vision, audition, and olfaction, but was also the seat of thought. He performed dissections of human bodies for research purposes. Health and disease are matters of equilibrium, with health being a balance and disease a rupture of that balance. He developed the two-aspect theory of the soul. Hippocrates is known as the father of ancient medicine. According to Hippocrates, a disease of an individual is a disturbance of the harmony of the elements as manifested in the humors. The theory of four humors came from the theory of four elements. The humors are the bodily fluids that exist within the human body in perfect balance. The four humors are the phlegm, the blood, the yellow bile, and the black bile. It is believed that if a person has too much or too little humor in their body, they are likely to develop a disease. The Hippocratic school was the first to relate brain to the conscious life, including the emotions. Later, Roman philosopher Galen formulated a concept of personality types based on the theory of humorism. He explained the four temperaments, sanguine, phlegmatic, choleric, and melancholic, are based on the balance of humors in the body. He says that a sanguine person has too much blood, a phlegmatic person suffers from excess phlegm, a choleric person suffers from excess yellow bile, and the melancholic suffers from the excess black bile. Socrates devoted his life and work to moral philosophy and to the search for moral good, virtue, and justice. The main method he used was dialectics. Dialectics was the method of seeking knowledge by question and answer. Through this, he tried to teach men how ignorant they were and to help them know themselves. Plato was the author of some 31 philosophical dialogues. In 387 BC, he founded his own school of philosophy, the Academy. Plato defined three aspects of the psyche, that is the reason, feeling and appetite. He also wrote about the duality of the psyche and the relationship between mind and body. He believed that the action of humors of the body affects one's mental state. Madness and ignorance for Plato were diseases of the mind brought about by the body. He also discussed sense perception. He believed that excess pain and pleasure are the greatest diseases of the mind. He indicated that people in great joy or great pain cannot reason properly. Hence, sense perception, desire, feeling, and appetite are products of the body and are at war with the mind. This is similar to Freud's notations about the it, ego, and superego. Plato also studied neuroscience. He believed that the seat of the psyche and its aspects, that is, the reason, feeling, and appetite, reside in the cerebrospinal marrow. The immortal aspect has a separate place in the brain. He believed that the blood vessels serve as the means for conveying sensations through the body. Plato used storytelling and literatures to illustrate points about the psyche. In Plato's Symposium, he presents a dialogue on the meaning of eros or love in which each participant offers their interpretations. He discusses two kinds of love. They are profane and sacred. The first is concerned with the body and the second with the psyche, that is the mind and character. Many scholars have used Plato's notations to draw conclusions about human nature. For example, Freud's notations about the personality being dependent on the it, ego, and superego are similar to Plato's three aspects of the psyche. And Carl Jung's notations about the libido and its general non-specialized drive character seem to stem from the early drive theories of Plato. Aristotle's book, De Anima, meaning On the Soul, is the first book to treat psychology as a systematic philosophy. It developed notations about the psyche. He founded the philosophical psychology. Aristotle studied with Plato for 20 years. Aristotle was the first to philosophize on the basis of science. Medieval period are considered from the 4th or 5th century of the Common Era to the middle or end of the 13th century Common Era. In Western and Central Europe, the first part of the Middle Ages until the 11th century is known as the Dark Ages. That is when the relative political and economic backwardness of society, followed by the collapse of the Roman Empire in the West and the breakdown of the Mediterranean world. There was no formal discipline called psychology in the Middle Ages, but there were a number of medieval writers, particularly from the 13th century, discussed concerns similar to those of present-day psychologists. Avicenna and Albertus Magnus seem to have been genuinely interested in psychological theory. It is possible to discern at least two important psychological traditions in the writing of this period, that is, a medical and a philosophical one, both stemming from ancient predecessors. Medieval ideas about cognitive psychology derive from two major sources, that is, the writings of Aristotle's, especially his work on the soul, and the theory of the inner senses. Aristotle's De Anima may be the most popular psychological text of all time. It was prescribed for Bachelor of Arts degrees throughout Europe until the end of Middle Ages. A number of 13th century philosophers who were also members of religious orders wrote about psychological issues, paying particular attention to perception, cognitive psychology, emotion, and the will. Some of those writers are Albert Magnus, St. Thomas Aquinas, Roger Bacon, and William of Ockham. The theologian Aquinas gave a detailed theory of the emotions. Most ancient theorists had held to theories of vision in which some quality was emitted by the eyes. Islamic scholars such as Avicenna and Al-Hasan pointed out the weakness of such theories and produced the accounts of visual perception in which the eyes were just the recipients of information. Simon Kemp, in his book Medieval Psychology, outlines two major influences on medieval psychology. They are the beliefs of Christians and the views of the classical philosophers and physicians. In 1929, Edwin Boring in his book, A History of Experimental Psychology, wrote that late medieval thinking was based largely on theology and hence tended to be opposed to science. In 1941, Gregory Zylberg, in his book, History of Medical Psychology, claimed that medieval medical practitioners were afraid to look into either normal or abnormal psychology and that the mentally ill were frequently regarded either as possessed by a devil or as witches. Many consider the 17th and 18th century as the birth of modern psychology. I will present some key events from then on. In 1758, William Battle's publication of Treatise on Madness marked the beginning of modern psychology. The 19th century was the time in which psychology was established as an empirical accepted science. In 1840, an American educator, Frederick Augustus Roach, published his book Psychology or a View of Human Soul, including Anthropology. In 1878, G. Stanley Hall became the first American to earn a PhD in psychology. He founded the American Psychological Association. In 1879, Wilhelm Wundt established the first experimental psychology lab in Leipzig, Germany. It was dedicated to the study of structuralism. This event is considered as the starting point of psychology as a separate science. In 1883, G. Stanley Hall opens the first experimental psychology lab in the US at Johns Hopkins University. In 1885, Hermann Ebbinghaus publishes his seminar on memory, in which he describes learning and memory experiments he conducted on himself. In 1886, Sigmund Freud begins offering therapy to patients in Austria. In 1888, James Cattell becomes the first professor of psychology at the University of Pennsylvania. He published Mental Tests and Measurements, marking the advent of psychological assessment. In 1890, William James published Principles of Psychology. In the same year, Sir Francis Galton established correlation techniques to understand the relationships between variables in intelligence studies. In 1892, G. Stanley Hall forms the American Psychological Association, enlisting 42 members. In 1895, Alfred Binet forms the first psychological lab devoted to psychodiagnosis. In 1898, Edward Thorndike develops the law of effect. In 1900, Sigmund Freud published his landmark, The Interpretation of Dreams. In 1901, the British Psychological Society is established. In 1905, Mary Calkins was elected as the first woman president of the American Psychological Association. In 1905, Alfred Binet introduced the intelligence test. In 1906, Ivan Pavlov published his findings on classical conditioning. In 1907, Carl Jung published The Psychology of Dementia Precox. In 1912, Edward Thorndike published Animal Intelligence, which led to the development of the theory of operant conditioning. In the same year, Max Wertheimer published Experimental Studies of the Perception of Movement, that led to the development of Gestalt psychology. In 1913, Carl Jung began to depart from Freudian views and developed his own theories, which he referred to as analytical psychology. In the same year, John B. Watson published Psychology as the Behaviorist Views, which established the concept of behaviorism. In 1915, Freud published his work on repression. In 1920, Watson and Rosalie Rainer published Research on Classical Conditioning of Fear with their subject, Little Albert. In 1932, Jean Piaget became the foremost cognitive theorist with his publication, The Moral Judgment of Children. In 1942, Carl Rogers developed the practice of client-centered therapy, which encouraged respect and positive regard for patients. In 1952, the first diagnostic and statistical manual of mental disorders was published. In 1954, Abraham Maslow published Motivation and Personality, describing his theory of hierarchy of needs. He is among the founders of humanistic psychology. In 1958, Harry Harlow published The Nature of Love, which described the importance of attachment and love in rhesus monkey. In 1961, Albert Bandura conducted his now famous Bobo doll experiment, in which child behavior is described as a construct of observation, imitation, and modeling. In 1963, Bandura first described the concept of observational learning to explain personality development. In 1974, Stanley Milgram published Obedience to Authority, which described the findings of his famous obedience experiments. In 1980, the DSM-3 was published. In 1990, Noam Chomsky published On Nature, Use, and Acquisition of Language. In 1991, Steven Pinker published an article introducing his theories as to how children acquire language, which he later published in his book, The Language Instinct. In 1994, the DSM-4 was published. In the beginning of this century, genetic researchers finished mapping human genes with the aim of isolating the individual chromosome responsible for mental dysfunction. In 2002, Steven Pinker published The Blank Slate, arguing against the concept of tabula rasa, that is, the theory that the mind is a blank state at birth. And Avashlam Kaspi offered the first evidence that genetics are associated with a child's response to insults. In the same year, psychologist Daniel Kahneman is awarded the Nobel Prize in Economics for his research on how judgments are made in the face of uncertainty. In 2010, Simon Levey published Gay, Straight, and the Reason Why, which argues that sexual orientation emerges from prenatal differentiation in the brain. In 2013, the DSM-5 was released. In that edition, the American Psychological Association removed gender identity disorder from the list of mental illnesses, replaced it with gender dysphoria to describe a person's discomfort with his or her gender. In 2014, John O'Keefe, May Britt Mosser, and Edward Mosser shared the Nobel Prize for their discovery of cells that constitute a positioning system in the brain key to memory. In the same year, US President Barack Obama announced the 10-year brain initiative to map the activity of every neuron in the human brain. In the same year, Stanislas Dehaene, Giacomo Rizzolatti, and Trevor Robbins were awarded the Brand Prize for their research on higher brain mechanisms underpinning literacy, numeracy, motivated behavior, social cognition, and their disorders. And in the same year, Brenda Milner, Marcus Reschel, and John O'Keefe received the Kavli Prize in Neuroscience for the discovery of specialized brain networks for memory and cognition. In 2015, the journal Psychology Today announced that it will no longer accept ads for gay conversion therapy and is deleting medical practitioners who list such therapy in their professional profiles. In the same year, the American Psychological Association barred psychologists from participating in national security interrogations at sites violating international law. And in the same year, a team led by Brian Nosek of the University of Virginia published an article in Science that revealed that only 39 of 100 studies published in major psychology journals could be replicated. Please share these videos with everyone who is preparing for this exam, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.